Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Company of Heroes 2. Here we are again, as always, as it is my favorite video game. Joining me is Mr. Magpie, this crazy old Brit that some of you may have heard of.
Hi, GG the Machine. Hi, how's it going?
Pretty damn good. Also, just as a disclaimer, I'm a little bit under the influence of alcohols. So this cast may be a little bit different to what you're used to. But yeah, Magpie's pretty funny. He's a crazy Brit. He has his own channel, so you should check him out. Do you even have a custom URL?
I do now have a custom URL as of just about a few days ago. Yeah,
oh, that's
so
good.
I'm at Magpie, youtube.com/c/magpie842.
Okay, now I left you a comment on your video that said you don't have to actually plug the slash C. You just say youtube.com/whatever the fuck it is.
Is that right?
Yeah, no, the C is unnecessary. Same with, like, user. Like, my URL is, like, youtube.com/user/ownedmachine0, but, like, it just redirects. Like, if you just type it in without, like, the prefix, it actually works. Yeah. Anyway.
Professional to the end, then. Brilliant.
Yeah. There we go. So, today it's going to be HQ Mule as our British at the south of Arnhem checkpoint, and his opponent.
Spawning in the north. Playing as Vermax, it's going to be FOG's Casparitus, who we might just call Casper, because that's a bit of a mouthful.
Yes, it is. He's actually, I think, streaming right now, but whatever. This is a live game, so we have no idea if it's going to be a good game or an awful one. That's kind of the surprise of live observe. Like, whenever
that's
Blake
true,
and
yeah,
I...
adds to the spice of life.
Yeah, whenever Blake and I cast, we always just do replays, well, generally, but... Like, the problem with replays is you don't have the synchronizing tool, so for, like, Skype casting, it's a lot easier to do live observer games. So Arnhem Checkpoint, a game that, or map that revolves around the center quite a fair bit. So we see HQ Mule and Cabarrus just fighting over the middle as we see the MG in that garrison there, obviously forcing out the infantry section there. Really want to put the Vickers in the garrison. Vickers generally have better damage, so they can actually duel those MGs at long range.
So, on this map, Arnhem Checkpoint, I mean, you play the game a little bit, you're experienced with all the factions. Would you say that this map favours Vermacht or British forces, or is it about even?
Well, I would say it is actually pretty even. It's certainly, like, a really strong map for US, in particular, able to make use of their light vehicle play. British, though, don't really have as much as those light vehicles, but as I say that, like, this actually is the new patch. I think it was the 15th of January, where the AEC has got, like, crazy buffed. So I would not be surprised to see that.
Yeah, I agree, yeah. I mean, for those of you who aren't aware, the game was patched a couple of days ago, and the AEC now has both increased damage and a slightly wider splash against infantry, so it'll be interesting to see if HQ Mull decides to pluck for the little scout car. And I'm kind of hoping he does, actually. It'll be nice to see the changes.
Yeah, me too. I haven't actually casted or I haven't even played with it, so this will be my first sample. Aside from watching AE's video, where he actually, like, showed the video in the cheat mod or whatever, it's a really good video format, actually. Like, rather than just being like, hey, this is the patch notes, and talking for 10 minutes about things, he is like, hey, this is the patch notes, and this is it in gameplay. So that was kind of cool. Bit of a shout-out there.
That was actually super useful.
Yeah. Did you see it as well?
No, I didn't. Is that AE?
Oh, yeah, the Brit guy. So basically, he talked about the notes, but then he actually opened up, like, cheat mod where you can, like, spawn units and stuff, and then he showcased the AEC in different circumstances and showed you, like, the damage. But, I mean, the problem with that is, like, unit performance varies so much depending on RNG, so, like, you can't always get a fair understanding until you actually have, like, a few games. So we have a pretty fast sniper. It's a great map for the sniper, but at the same time, it's a great map for light vehicles. So, you know, it's very open, it's hard to mine. So if the AEC does find that sniper, you can trace it down and kill it pretty easily on retreat.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, the sniper's always a popular choice when you play as Vermax against British. Obviously, Tommies and other high manpower squads gonna give you a lot of veterancy and cost your opponent a lot of manpower when you start picking them down. But now that the AEC's been buffed,
yeah,
that seems like a pretty attractive counter.
4:30,
and
he's already building it.
And we've got one on the production queue now, sorry.
Yeah. Coming out very fast, and HQ Milk doesn't have a lot of territory, rather. So he has to have a pretty big impact with this. The only problem with the AEC is I'm pretty sure it doesn't do much against garrisons. And there's an MG in the garrison, there's a Grenadier squad, so I don't think he's going to be able to dislodge the center. But currently, there's not even a tier 2 yet from Casper, and he does really need to get out a pack or some Shreks. because the 2-2-2 won't cut it. Of course, it gets destroyed unless he has like four or so Panzerfausts in a row. You know, which is just too much munitions. So currently, Ace is on the field. So take note, it is 5:15, much earlier than the Panzer II.
Yeah, that is a lot earlier. This AEC is definitely going to be able to police the field now that it's more effective against infantry targets, which is pretty much everything for the Axis player. Yeah, that should be pretty good. So, do you play a lot of Wehrmacht when you play as Axis, or do you split your time, or are you an Overcommand guy?
More Wehrmacht than Overcommand. I tend to play them pretty evenly. Like, I'm top 100 for all of them, so I like to try and play them at a pretty good mixture to keep a unbiased opinion of them.
Okay.
As for playstyle,
yeah, I mean,
though,
makes sense.
I definitely prefer Wehrmacht over OKW. Like OKW.
Okay, so let's say that you're a Wehrmacht player and you see this scout car comes out at you at about 5.5 minutes. Like, what's your best response? You think pack guns?
Oh, it certainly have to be a pack. Like, Pegrins are going to be good if you can put them in garrisons or behind heavy cover, but out in the open or behind medium cover, you're just going to get killed by the AEC. It's just going to burst you down. In the same way that, like, you know, Shreks aren't amazing against Stuarts because the Stuarts and T-70s can wipe them pretty easily. So the pack's the safer choice. Telemines are going to be a good option as well, especially as we see Casper hasn't spent any of his munitions. Because, you know, unlike the Stuart, there's no critical repair. So the Telemine's going to have a pretty big impact. I can't even remember if the Telemine one-shots the AEC. It probably would, I think.
I don't think I've ever seen that, so I can't say. But an interesting thing here, the Wehrmacht player's gone for the GR-34cm mortar, which he has capping this point. He's got some grenadiers and a sniper in the hood. But the British player saw this position, and he decided opted not to attack with the AEC, which is an interesting choice, because I think it can pretty much take all of that, and there's no hard AT on the field yet. So
yeah,
I think if I was HQ Mull, I probably would have tried out and tried to get some kills in there.
Exactly, he's being way too defensive, considering he has a huge advantage.
Wow,
that... He did that for no reason. Yeah, considering
that,
he has
a
massive... That was, surely. Yeah, he had a massive advantage. He saw the sniper, the MG, the mortar, the Gren. So he knows that there's no counter on the field. But all he's doing right now is he's just buying Casper time to actually field a counter. We have a squad of P-Grens being built, and there's 150 munis in the bank. So it will no doubt be a squad of Panzertrecks. And with these garrisons in the middle, I think it's going to be a very strong deterrent.
Yeah, that's true. I think by concentrating all of his forces in the middle, deploying the MG, the Grenadiers, with the Sniper on backup, it doesn't really matter so much that the AEC can kite the Panzer Grenadiers if the Panzer Grenadiers are just going to be garrisoned and holding middle, which is kind of the Axis strong point anyway. So, kind of ameliorating some of the AEC's newfound anti-infantry strength that way. I wonder if he'll go for a pack gun as well.
Yeah, I think it's just a big misplay here from HQ Mull being way too defensive when he has the advantage. And so we see on even the left side as well, the snipers moving over, telemines being planted on the road, well, kind of, not exactly the road, but close to it. It does get revealed though, so you will have to cancel that one. Other than that though, Casper has a pretty big lead in the VPs. It's 416 against 500, so yeah. And also, like, the thing with HQ Mull is he hasn't put that Vickers in that church, which can be really good dislodging the middle. Like, the mortar was smart because you kind of expect the Brits to have that like, the middle-centered garrison play with the Vickers, and the mortar will obviously dislodge that, but he just hasn't even tried.
Yeah, seems like those telemines actually got finished in the location where they were revealed, which is a little awkward from Casper. So the British player probably suspects that there are mines there. Does he have... Yeah, he's got a metal detector on the Royal Engineers, which are backing up the AEC in mid. Actually, those Panzer Grenadiers got two Shreks. They're in the building. They got two good hits on the AEC. That's going to force the scout car back for now.
Yeah, the smoke was actually on cooldown after he misclicked. So if things went worse, he almost could have lost that one. And we have the minesweepers online already for HQ Mull. It's interesting that Casper actually finished the mines despite it being revealed. So I wouldn't be surprised. I think we'll just see HQ just go over and clear them because he knows they were planted there. Vickers on the cutoff though is always nice to see. We'll prevent the P-Grants from capping that one.
So here's a question. If you start building some mines and you get interrupted and have to abandon them and then you cancel them, do you get the full munitions cost
back? Oh, you do. Yeah. You get the entire refund. So long as it hasn't finished. Even with, like, the S mines, like, you get the full refund and then but it cancels it all. So doing that's pretty clever.
That's
and, like, a lot of times, like, if you build a mine, someone will like try and fire a rifle grenade on it, and then if you just cancel the mine during the rifle grenade's projectile, like, you get the full refund and they've just wasted a rifle nade. So yeah, you should always cancel it if it's been revealed, unless it's like area denial, like if it's S mines and you don't actually care that they know it's there, for example. But I mean, especially if telemines are expensive as they are, you generally want to put them somewhere unexpected. But either way, it will be Kaspar. He's locked in his elite troops, has access to the stormtroopers if he wants to. I think the sniper is waiting for a counter snipe.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, that's pretty typical, I think, when in the Brits versus Wehrmacht matchup. And the scout car's going to push on into mid here. I'm hoping we're going to get to see some sweet shots into infantry squads that aren't in a garrison, so we can kind of get a feel for its new power, you know?
Yeah, so far it's had a pretty lousy impact, and really it's only been firing at garrisons. It's not bad against garrisons, but it obviously won't have the big impact. So this stormtrooper's actually upgrading to a Shrek. So the only problem with that is they only have a single Shrek. It's nowhere near as potent as the Pigrens that, of course, get two Shreks, but it is a fair bit cheaper. They have the cloak, so you can ambush with them pretty effectively.
That's good stuff. Yeah, we've got like an exchange here between the two MGs, both in garrison. That's one the Vickers should win based on its heavier DPS, but there's a lot more backup here in the form of a GR34, some Grenadiers who are actually awkwardly at the back, not actually contributing to this fight, and of course the Panzer Grenadiers and the Stormtroopers who are firing on in. So I reckon the Wehrmacht player is going to hold here in mid. That's going to force the British player to diversify, and to that end, on the left flank,
that Vickers was white.
Tommy's with medpack moving out. And on the right flank, there is a Vickers, and the AEC looks like it might be cycling onto the right. So maybe HQ Mal is just going to say, you know what, Kaspar, you can have the middle, and I'm going to take these flanks.
Yeah, the only problem with that playstyle, though, on Arnhem is that cutoff at the south, it does prevent the left side from being captured. So you have to like either focus the right side entirely or at least defend that cutoff. Because if you lose that church, and if they just place a Gren squad or an MG in that church, you can't really hold the left side. So we actually saw the Vickers go down to the mortar during that engagement. Is a second mortar though here from HQ Mull on that cutoff. And we actually had the arty strike being called down from the sniper, which did destroy that garrison on the side.
Yeah, did the squad manage to get out?
It did, yeah.
Okay, cool. Oh yeah, here it is.
So now we have three Shreks. And, oh, actually, the Faust came through on the AEC, moving the Pigrens up, but there's so much supporting AT. I don't think we'll see this AEC go down. The smoke's available as well. Snipers may get a counter snipe. I don't think he's actually revealed the Brit sniper just yet. Going for the snipe now. Will he get it? Yeah, there's the Wehrmacht sniper taken out. Nice patience there by HQ. Well, he waited until the sniper was revealed before revealing his own. He hadn't fired a single shell. Apart from that, like, the arty strike. Oh, Panzer Shrek actually misses. That would have taken out the AEC. He's going to retreat through the Vickers, but just kidding, because the Vickers is facing the wrong direction. Infantry section, however, may get it.
I think all in all, that was a pretty classy engagement for HQ Mull. Whoa, that mortar round, though. Was that a mortar round?
Yeah, it was a mortar round.
Wow, getting a squad wipe there. Damn, that was pretty unlucky. But I think overall, a pretty classy engagement from HQ Mull. Getting the AEC tagged by the Faust was unfortunate, and he did nearly lose it. As you say, the RNG on that last Panzer Shrek was the difference there. But, you know, he had the Vickers in a nice position. He managed to inflict some losses. He picked up the sniper, and he's forced a lot of the Wehrmacht troops back for now. So there might be a window here where if he can get back on his feet faster than his opponent, he may be able to push mid. The Axis hardpoint there is mostly redeployed onto the left flank, so there could be an opening here for HQ to try and make a move here and shift the battle lines a little bit. And I'm sure he'd love to get a Vickers up into this forward building in mid and try and keep the Axis player out of the mid and the right by using that building there.
Are you referring to the northern garrison in the middle VP?
Yes, that's right, yeah.
So just one thing with that garrison, if you actually look to the left, there's only a single window. So like holding that garrison is kind of hard as the south player. Whereas as the north player, you have four windows facing down. So
good knowledge, GG. Good knowledge, the machine. That's wow. You can tell. I've not played this map as much as you have. That is good stuff.
It's okay with MGs though, because you only really need a single window. But if you have a squad of infantry, and then on the left of that garrison, you have the truck and the sandbag, so you have heavy cover. So it's really easy to dislodge that garrison just by putting a squad in that heavy cover and just firing out against that garrison.
So I see HQ, he hasn't chosen his commander at the moment. He, do you reckon he's figured out right now what Kaspar's on? I mean, he hasn't seen any stun grenades as far as I know. Are there any G43 upgrades? Okay, there are G43 upgrades, though. So that narrows it down.
He went Stormtroopers. So it's pretty obvious he went Elite Troops.
Stormtroopers, aren't there?
Yeah.
Oh, that makes it pretty obvious. Okay, so, well, okay, based on the fact then that Kaspar knows, let's see, he's got Commando Reg, Royal Arty, and Royal Engineer. It's not really, there's no good counterpick there, so I guess that's why he's waiting.
Not really, but as Brits, you don't need, like, AT as a doctrine, because you have such hard-hitting AT. You have the Fireflies, the Comets, all on your base faction. It's not like kind of Soviets, where it's like, you know, I really want to have an IS-2, I need that AT. But, like, I don't think any Brit commander really has good AT on their doctrines. Yeah, I wonder what he'll go for. I mean, he has the artillery, which is awful, so I doubt we'll see Arty. If he was gonna go Royal Engineers, he probably would have already and gone for, like, a mortar and use the brace structure. A mortar actually would be nice, though. Ooh, section is actually wiped in the middle. Losing a very important squad there. Teleminer has been revealed by those retreating engineers.
Oh yeah, that's true, yeah. The, what is the ability called with the smoke barrage? It's the, oh yeah, the coordinated fire there, yeah. Was that what got the squad in mid?
Well, it was one of the infantry sections that were wiped. Like, HQ mobile squad. Okay. It was on retreat. He just retreated through those peak rooms. Yeah. Destroying those garrisons, kind of gradually depriving all those garrisons, which is probably working out in the favor of HQ Mull, given that he has the sniper, which is really good in open terrain. So the AEC is forcing away these squads. It's preventing the caps on the left side. But for now, there's a massive territory lead by Kaspar. He has the VP gain, he has the left, and he has the munitions point, so I think Kaspar's doing pretty well in this game so far, despite losing a couple of squads.
Yeah, I agree. I was just checking out the AEC to see how well it's been doing. It's nearly at 2-star so far, and it's got 8 kills all infantry, so I think the change in the recent patch is affecting it, but whether that's actually having much of an impact on this map, well, I don't know. Like, what do you think?
I think that he would have had the impact if he used it more aggressively in the early game, which he didn't. It's got some kills,
that's
but
a good point.
I'm pretty sure it hasn't had any wipes. And one thing we actually haven't looked at is the tech of Kaspar. He's gone straight for his tier 4, getting a Panther immediately, really showing his fuel lead. And we haven't even mentioned the fuel caches. He has 2 of these fuel caches, giving him an even further lead, which is further just showing how much of a lead he's had this game. And so having the tier 4... is so potent, especially with the elite troops. He has a Tiger Ace eventually. He'll also have his Panzerwerfer, which is amazing. Has his Panther. So, yeah, he's in a really good spot. I think HQMO is going to actually struggle.
I agree with you. Yeah, the Wehrmacht player is definitely in a really good spot. But the company command post is finished for the British player, and he hasn't actually spent any of his fuel yet. Like, there's no Centaur, there's no Cromwell on the way, and he does have enough fuel for a Firefly. So when he sees the Panther come on, he can counter. He can pick the Firefly and restrict the window. I mean, there's going to be like a 1.5 minute window or so when that Panther's got like reign of the field, but then the Firefly should be able to shut it down quite a lot.
Yeah, he's going to have to go Firefly, but there's 3 Shreks on the field, so the Firefly can get taken out pretty easily. I mean, the Panther can 1v1 the Firefly if it gets in close, and there isn't any supporting AT. There's no 6-pounder AT guns, there's no PRs, which he may actually go for because he has 3 squads of the engineers, he has a lot of munitions banked up, so Piat spam could be a pretty good option.
He does have the AEC, that can help in a fight with the Panther.
That's true. You're going for the sniper. There's no Pintle just yet. We'll come online now. Decides not to chase it all the way into the base. Yeah, the AEC has the target critical, which can actually immobilize a tank. Pretty crazy if you get that chance, but normally it's just a damage engine.
Actually, you know what? That pairs up really nicely with the Firefly rockets.
Yeah. If it's immobilized, it can't dodge those Firefly Tulips rockets, it'll just get destroyed. It looks like this Vickers in the trench will get cleared out by the mortar. Trenches are nice, but they are countered pretty hardcore by the mortars, especially it's Vet 3 now, it's had a pretty strong impact.
Yeah, the GR-34 has always been one of the better mortars in the game, I think. It's the rate of fire that does it, really. Just fires so much faster than anybody else's mortar, and that lets you clock up a lot more damage.
So we actually have the Comet coming out. So the Comet's going to be great against the Panther. And, Gavin bombing that church. Really evac the MG. Ooh. Actually, it doesn't destroy the church. It's very rare that you'll see garrisons survive a Gavin bomb.
Yeah, that's pretty potent stuff. But it's interesting what you're saying about the Comet. Do you think that can 1v1 a Panther?
Well,
I mean, all other things being equal?
Not really. But it kind of can, right? And it just it holds its own. Like, it comes down to whoever has the most supporting AT. It's like, you're not really going to kill the Panther, but the Panther isn't going to kill you either. Like, they're both so strong, they both have enough speed that they can disengage very easily. And so then it comes down to who can bait into Shreks, who can bait into a 6-pounder. So I guess it can deal with the Panther, but not, like, kill it, if that makes sense.
Yeah, sure. I mean, like, Brits are my preferred faction, but I tried the Comet, like, I don't know, 2-3 times, and I just kind of thought, man, it's not for me. And I don't think it's ever come up in any game I've ever casted, so...
Well, Comet's really strong.
I don't really get the chance to see it very often.
Like, the Panther has a lot stronger armor, so the Panther will win the 1v1, but the Comet has really good anti-infantry, so the Comet's going to be able to force retreats and wipe squads much more effectively than the Panther. So in that regard, the Comet is kind of regarded as being better because it lends itself well to map control, where Panther, like, it drives up to squads and it has a couple of MGs and it's like, yeah, you're going to have to retreat sometime in the near future. Whereas a Comet can just one-shot a squad if you get a lucky hit. So it has more potency. But yeah, the Panther is certainly going to be able to win those 1v1 engagements. Rifle nade comes through, almost wipes the infantry section, does retreat it just in time, however.
Yeah, pretty good hit here. The SDS sniper turns up just too late to get a shot on the Panther as he rolls out of town. The Comet and the AEC are waiting on standby, ready to take advantage of a stricken Panther if he was able to get the target weak point. But that's not going to be the case.
Yeah, having the emergency war speed as well really helps out on the Comet. Getting that that speed boost to flank the Panther down. So the AEC, he's going to have a good impact if he can get the rear armor. If he can penetrate, get the flank down. We do see now the Panther's getting collapsed upon. AEC's actually on the road, so we'll have the extra speed. Starting not to commit to it. Panther's a little bit too far off as well, but he has forced it back a little bit. He has 3 squads of engineers, which will give him a lot of repairs. That's one big influence as well, is whoever has the most repairs can then have the prolonged tank engagements.
Yeah, I find that's especially pronounced when you're playing like one of the older factions, Soviets or Wehrmacht, against some of the newer factions who have some faster repair options. You do need to like stack up multiple engineer squads, usually.
This AEC, though.
Slightly concerning. Oh yeah, sorry.
Does
AEC
take
it. Pop smoking out of here.
Takes a single Shrek. I don't know if the second Shrek would have actually killed him if he hit. Panther's being repaired, but there's only 2 pyros there, so they will take a while to actually repair. And so the Comet's on full health. So this is the sort of engagement now where the Comet could go in, pop the emergency war speed. The only problem for him is that there's the Panzer Shreks there. So he has to force away the Shreks, whether it's with the sniper or with the Vicar suppression. And then Kasparov's going to eventually have his Tiger Ace. But he's actually building
a second Panther.
Yeah.
So, interesting choice. I like it. I think Panther tanks are pretty like amazing, and the best like compliment for a Panther tank is another Panther, pretty much. I mean, if you're in a luxurious position where you can build another one, it's really nice to be able to go for it. Also, with the Tiger Ace being all the way at 17 CP, you can easily squeeze in a few more units.
Yeah, exactly.
So, second Panther going to be joining. Surely.
And the Tiger Ace requires no fuel, so you don't need to stock up any fuel like you would for a regular Tiger.
That's so true. I think Kasparov's doing a really good job right now, just like policing the field, maintaining field control, like eking out this score advantage. But the one concern I have, okay, there we go. Just as I say that, he addresses it. He puts another Pioneer squad on the lineup. I was worried because he only has this one Pioneer squad, and they were down to like 2 men trying to repair for ages, and I was just worried for his repair speed. But another squad should help that out.
Man, that white phosphorus is brutal from the Comet. Forces the mortar away. I definitely agree with you. I think you got to have 2 Pioneers for a Panther or a Tiger, and then if you have like 2 Panthers, then you want to have, you know, 3 or so. Probably not more than 3 because it just drains your pop cap, but you really want to have that, especially when you call them the Tiger Ace. Then you get that manpower decrease, so you want to have all your Pioneer squads like beforehand. As for HQ Mule, he doesn't have enough fuel for a Firefly. He needs a Firefly, But in the meantime, we should maybe go for a couple of AT guns, maybe get a fuel cache to get in that extra fuel income. He has a fair bit of manpower banked up. Has locked in the Royal Engineer, so he has the AVRE. The AVRE is not going to be very good against two Panthers.
Yeah, good spot there, man. Nothing gets past you, does it? The Royal Engineer Regiment Commander gets chosen right then, and that has to be for the AVA, right?
Well, having the crew repairs is a really great ability as well. Command vehicle's okay. Awesome if you can put it on a universal carrier and just park it nearby. Yeah, I mean, it was either that or Commando Regiment. And Commando Regiment wouldn't have really helped him like that much. I don't know. I think he maybe should have picked up Commandos like a while ago. It was kind of a bit too late now. Because there's too many tanks, there's two Panthers. The Commandos won't have much impact.
Yeah, sure. This comet's trading pretty well against the Panthers it's been able to line up against, though. It's sneaking hits in there, here and there, and it's up to like one, nearly two-star vet getting on for anyway. Able to. Do you reckon that's because of the tank commander? It's vetting up so much faster than the Panthers, or do you reckon it's just actually done more damage?
Yeah, it has. I mean, he's been attack rounding through Fog of War. He's been hitting infantry as well. I think it's just a bit better micro on the comet tank. Alright, we've seen the Panther going in.
Gets caught out here.
Yeah, with the help of these Shreks, the Royal Engineers are going to be forcing away the Shreks, but the Comet is so low. Pops emergency war speed. Panther going in, doesn't have the Blitzkrieg just yet. Comet's on the road, AEC trying to cover for him. Will absorb the shots, gets the turret rotation disabled. Immobilized, wow, the immobilized, the crit repair comes through, the crit from the AEC. He's actually immobilized on the spot, he can't do anything. There's no support there.
Chain crits with the sniper here.
Yeah, and the turret rotation's disabled, so the AEC can go
Where's
for a flank.
Where's the second Panther in all this? The second Panther's busy taking care of a Vickers in a trench up to the right. He probably needs to come and help his friend out here. This is where all the money's fighting.
Oh, the immobilized disabled. It must be only a temporary thing.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, it's a temporary engine break.
Okay.
But still, I think there was an opportunity there, maybe, for a little bit of mayhem to be caused. I don't know. He probably didn't want to risk recommitting the comet, so actually, I understand why HQ Mull played that a little more cautiously. It seems like Firefly is the fuel spending of choice here for HQ, so he's going to have a fearsome tank destroyer on the field soon, and that will redress the balance of power.
Yeah.
I think maybe he'll be able to push these Panthers back with the comet and the AEC in support.
Regarding that comet, though, the comet was pretty safe, because it had enough health to take two shots, so he wasn't going to get, like, one-shotted by the Panther, but then also he could have, like, just attacked out of the, like, the vision of the Panther, because he had vision from the AEC, and the Panther has less vision range than it has attack range, so you can kind of attack back at it, and it was immobilized. Like, he couldn't turn the turret as well because of the other crit, so I think he could have, like, tried, and then if he was going to lose it, just, like, disengage, but I don't know, whatever, it doesn't matter, because now the Firefly is already here. Nothing wrong about playing it safe when you have a veteran of two comet. That's one thing that HQ Mull has going for him, is he will have that vet advantage, but also the Shreks are going to be flanking this comet. This could go pretty horribly. Firefly has opened up on this Panther, however. No tulip rockets just yet. Engineers are swarming down on these Peregrines. AEC is there as well.
Yeah, and the Sherman Firefly is just down at the south, cracking some rounds into that Panther. That forces a smoke and a retreat out of one of the Panthers. The other Panther still being repaired at the moment, actually. So there's probably going to be a window here for some armor to push out for the Brits, I think. There's only a half-health Panther, and that's probably going to want to get back and repair.
Second sniper here for HQ Mull, so we'll be able to deal away with those Peregrines. I think that's really the threat for HQ, is the Peregrines are turning the tank engagements toward Casper far too much. But that being said, HQ Mull is actually triple capped, and you see these VPs back pretty desperately, only on 150. It looks like he will actually lose the end squad in the middle. That one does fall. A bit of a shame there. So
yeah, that is a bit of a shame, but he's floating 480 manpower and only 35 fuel, so he can probably replace them if he really wants to.
Yeah.
But I see you. I share your concern about the victory score. I mean, the scoreline situation right now, 482 for the
sniper's wiped.
34.
Direct
that was
hit.
A lucky mortar round. My God, that GR34 has been like maybe MVP, I think, for the Wehrmacht player. It's been doing so well.
Yeah, so the sniper actually has 82 health, which means it can survive a direct mortar shot. The sniper must have actually been wounded. Same with this one here. This one has, well, it had a little bit less than 82 health. So when your snipers aren't at full health, you have to be very careful of indirect fire. Same with the Wehrmacht sniper, has enough health to survive a direct shot.
So how much, if a sniper has 82 health, how much damage does a direct mortar hit?
80.
Okay, wow.
Yeah, it's not much of a difference there. Third Panther's coming out.
This is like super useful information.
They did it intentionally on purpose to prevent sniper from getting one shot with the Vermark sniper. And so, yeah, wow, this Panther's getting low. It has the rear armor as well. Damage engine though from the Faust. The Firefly has moved. He could lose both of these Panthers. One of them actually falls. The second Panther as well. Looks like it will fall here. That Comet is so close. It will penetrate at a higher rate the closer it is. But he pops the smoke. Firefly misses the attack ground. Panther returns a shot. This Firefly has to be pretty careful as the second Panther is showing up. It's on full health. The two Pigrens are moving in. Well, the Pigrens and the Storm Pioneer, no, the Stormtroopers. AC.
Do you think there's a window here for this Comet tank to get taken out by the Vermac player?
Yeah, definitely will fall here. AC on the flank. Firefly does fire as well. This could actually swing either way. The Pigrens have moved up though. Comet's bouncing these shells. It's actually abandoned for now. There goes the critical. Doesn't get a damage engine, however. And the Panther will survive, but it's rear armor against the AEC. Gotta be careful with that. The rate of fire is not bad. Especially the Vet 3. And so the Tiger Ace will come any moment. He has 18 command points. Just needs a little bit more manpower for it. Trying to destroy it with the Stormtroopers. He may actually want to recapture that with these Engineers. Trying to force off the Stormtroopers first. Oh no, loses it. Whenever I say the word Storm, I just want to throw in Storm Pioneers.
Oh, it's the same with me with Jaeger Light Infantry and Faustrum Jaegers.
Yeah.
I always want to say one and not the other.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, Maul's doing a really good job right now of marshalling the victory points, which is what he needs to do. If you look at the scoreline, I mean, the main way he's going to lose this game is going to be being pushed out on score. So holding all three right now, pretty good. There are no forces on the right, though, so even one Axis squad could chew up a lot of ground out there.
Yeah.
What do we got out here, Capping? Tommy's out on the left flank.
Thing is, for HQ Mill, he really needs mines. Against the Tiger Ace, the only real chance that he has of actually killing it is it driving over a mine and then hitting, like, the Tulips rockets. Because, like, yeah, the Firefly is Vet 2, but the Tiger Ace, it has the 50 range. So the Firefly, it's really hard to kite. And the Tiger Ace rate of fire is so strong, the sight range is huge. It's really hard to actually use tank destroyers against the Tiger Ace. And the two Panthers on the field as well, this Firefly is going to have a pretty rough time. He has a fair bit of munitions, so considering he has that many engineers, he should have been placing more mines down. But he hasn't really had enough, like, map control to really have enough of those mines. Panther has found the snipers. He will retreat it now. Doing a fair bit of damage, actually, and the Firefly is a little bit late to respond, but he only got his engine repaired just now. Has the tulips. Will he actually go for it? He could deploy. Deploying them now. Will he actually kill the Panther here? Both of them do hit. One more shot will seal the deal, but can he actually penetrate the frontal armor? It hit Vet 2, giving that extra armor with the armored skirts. Let's see. All eyes on this Panther. Does he actually have vision? Oh, he gets the abandoned.
That was a pretty fantastic shot. An emergency war speed there coming down on the Sherman, making the difference there and able to
he
get
destroys
a kill.
It.
Take it out so it can't be remanned.
Oh man, this is
a pretty big swing.
This is turning into a fantastic game, and this was just like a random live game.
See, this is the joy of live games, man. When they turn out to be good, they're like extra special, you know.
Actually, this AEC though pops the smoke. Needs to get out of there.
He can take one more hit, I reckon.
Yeah.
So.
One more. If that was the Pigren squad, he may have lost it, but only the Stormtroopers.
Look at that emergency war speed there, the nitrous boost, that AEC getting a move on.
Yeah.
Oh, good stuff.
I have a feeling like the relic devs that worked on Brits may have played Move for Speed Underground 2.
Well, at least they didn't play Burnout.
They didn't play Burnout. Anyway, Casper only has a single Panther, and this Firefly is pretty much Vet 3. So, look, this Firefly, it may be able to manhandle this Tiger Ace if it comes on the field. He will need a second tank, though. Ideally, a Comet. With a Firefly, just like any other tank destroyer, you really want to have something to not only take vision, or give vision, but also to, like, absorb the shots. Because
the
tank destroyers on their own...
Yeah,
glorified meat shield. So the Comet's ideal, has a lot of health, a lot of armor. I mean, even a Cromwell wouldn't be too bad, but the Cromwell doesn't have the health or armor that a Comet does. It's a lot cheaper and a lot faster. I do like the S-mines on the right VP preventing the caps without the support of some minesweepers or sending a Firefly to crush them.
Yeah, there are some Tommies falling victims to those right now, actually. But it's interesting what you're saying about needing a tank. I do agree with you, the Firefly is definitely best used with a tank, but I think with the AC and two snipers, he may have enough disruption to have a pretty good crack at that Tiger Ace anyway. I mean, it'll depend on how the fight comes together, but I think he's got the tools at his disposal. If he uses them well, if he gets the right engagement, I think he can deal with a Tiger Ace and a Panther. Maybe, I see.
Yeah, we'll have
to
see.
The Tiger Ace just now rolling on, it's pretty intimidating.
There's still no Piats from these infantry sections. Also, the Universal Carrier would be fantastic. Either. The command of getting the extra rate of fire, the extra accuracy. I think it's received accuracy as well. The Tiger Ace has revealed itself, may even wipe these snipers. Negative cover as well. Oh, gets one of them. Second one retreats for his dear life. That was a Veterancy 3 sniper as well, so a bit of a blow. Firefly not quite in the position to return its fire. AEC bouncing shots for days to be expected against that Tiger Ace. He's actually going, no, AEC, you can't pick that fight, my friend.
Yeah, you can try. So, okay, well, okay, how about this then? How about instead of going for another tank, what if Mull was to go for another Firefly?
Yeah, it could work. He doesn't have the munitions for a double Tulips, which would be fantastic.
Okay, good point, yep.
But, yeah, not bad. Like, the problem with the Firefly is the rate of fire is so bad, and actually he's collapsing upon the Firefly out in the open, takes two shots, there's no support here, he may lose this one. This could be the end of the game here. The rate of fire on the Tiger Ace is just too much. Tiger Ace does get the killing blow in the end. Oh no, HQ. You can't leave your tank destroyer out in the open without vision. You want to have squads in front of it.
Yeah, that was a sad mistake. Just a couple of seconds of lack of attention there. He was probably just away doing something else, and that's all it takes for the Vet 3 Firefly to fall victim to this Tiger Ace. And with that, you have to feel like the chances for the British player in this game running pretty slim. There's still an AEC getting mass repaired, but that's not going to be enough to keep away these cats.
Yeah.
So there's a comet coming, so that could be something. But do you think the Panther and the Tiger would take a dive if the comet rolls onto the field?
Oh, absolutely. The comet just is going to get slaughtered. Doesn't really stand
a
fair chance.
I like your style. You just know these things. I'm like, do you reckon they'll take a dive? And I'm like on the fence about it. And you're like, no, absolutely. I would be in there for blood. I like it.
Well, I mean,
you got that killer instinct.
Unless this AEC is just completely blowing out of control. He has actually got the immobilized.
Come on, AEC. He's got
pops of smoke.
He's got like 10 squads of engineers. He can do this. I say optimistically.
I think my game sounds are maybe a little bit too loud, so I do apologize if I have kind of drowned you out with the glorious sound of tank shells and explosions. But, I mean,
I can hear you at least.
Just...
Yeah, no, I mean, I was just thinking to myself earlier, I might have your voice down just a little bit too low.
Yeah.
But, you know, this is an evolving process for everybody out there. This is an evolving process.
Oh, man.
This Panther!
He's gonna lose it! One more shot will seal the deal. Rear armor as well. No, just kidding! He actually survives that shot. See, I can be incorrect sometimes.
Wow, I can't believe this game's still alive. Mull's still in possession of two of the victory points. He's not bleeding out right now. And he's kind of got the tools. I mean, the Axis armor is going to be forced to retreat. There's no way the Tiger Ace wants to take this fight by itself. It's too important. You can't risk it.
Yeah, the one thing to bear...
Savage rifle grenade. Not getting any kills, though, in mid.
Yeah, it's because he's behind heavy cover.
Oh, the mortar!
So, in case you don't know, like, heavy cover, you get 50% reduced damage. So that will affect explosives. This AEC... Smoke's actually on cooldown. He probably would be fine if he had the smoke available, but he doesn't. He's on the road, however. But the Tiger Ace misses that last shot. Yeah, so Rathalnator won't one-shot a squad if they're behind heavy cover. Whereas if they're behind medium cover is only accuracy. Received accuracy is reduced, not received damage.
Okay, I'm with you.
Yeah.
This is all super useful stuff, by the way. Your game knowledge is pretty good.
Thank you. I mean, I have, like...
I play the game a lot, but I don't know the exact stats and figures for all these things. That's impressive. It's really interesting to know as well.
I have, like, 2,500 hours, so I would certainly hope that I know things about this video game.
I thought I had a lot of hours. Wow.
Yeah. Also, like...
Wow, well...
A lot of this knowledge just comes from the forums. Like, browsing, like, Cruz's threads and stuff, where he just tells you game stats and stuff. But yeah, it's pretty handy to know. So basically, like, if, like, going behind, like, medium cover is actually bad for machine guns, because you just get wiped by grenades, like, really easily. So, like, with machine guns and support weapons, you kind of either want to be, like, behind heavy cover or nothing at all. Because if you're behind light cover, you just get clumped and wiped by a grenade. It's not really worth it. We actually have the anti-building flame support, so
I was wondering if we're going to see that this game.
150 munitions.
Like, too late though.
I think that's kind of a waste, really, because he didn't actually need to clear that, because it was only a Stormtrooper squad with a Shrek. What he really should have done is got Piats on his engineers and used that against the Panther and the Tiger Ace.
I completely agree. I think that was a little bit of a flip and click, like just a hasty click, you know?
Well, it was a hasty wipe on those engineers.
Good hits on the Tiger Ace.
Just to confirm, actually, so this timestamp, 46, 7, 8, 9,
yep,
10.
Yep, we're spot on.
Cool. All right, so we have the Panther leading the charge with its rear armor, and the six pounders here with the AEC. I gotta say though, fantastic preservation of this AEC by HQ, and he's actually been using it. Like sometimes you see like, oh wow, this Kubel is still alive, but like no one, like the player doesn't actually use it. This AEC has been pretty active, and he still has it, which is pretty awesome to see.
It has been pretty active, but I think mostly it's an anti-infantry unit. Like, I mean, well, at least as far as the Tiger Ace goes, it can hurt the Panther a little bit, but
it can immobilize Panthers.
I'm not convinced it's being like super useful right now. And the other thing is, it is still alive and he has preserved it amazingly. I think he's done everything he can, but let's not forget, it is only alive because a couple of RNGs missed here and there, that Tiger Ace and earlier on in the game, Panzer Shrek as well. So, I don't know. I think this AEC has done well, but I don't know.
One thing to bear in mind, you probably don't know this either, so with Blitzkrieg and with Overdrive, Overdrive is like the Soviet light vehicles, you get received accuracy, like as a bonus, so you're less likely to hit those vehicles when they activate Blitzkrieg and Overdrive. I don't actually know if it's the same for emergency war speed, but I'm assuming it is, which would explain all the misses on these vehicles. We see the Tiger Ace is actually going in, Six Pounder is refacing, Comet's getting a little bit low, half HP. And yeah, we see a lot of misses against the emergency war speed, so I do have a feeling it actually does affect that.
It would seem to make sense, I think. It would seem like if that's like a common game mechanic, then I think it would make sense. Although that's going to be an interesting one to look up and make sure of.
Yeah, look at the MG on the right side. It actually gets wiped by the AEC. It is actually destroyed, so it can't be recruited. The AEC definitely is having an impact. It's still able to wipe those squads, prevent those caps on the VPs. HQ Muller is just playing this fantastically, and... And like Casper, like he's actually kind of struggling now because the Tiger Ace is draining his manpower so badly. He doesn't have any fuel income either, but he actually has enough fuel banked up for a second Panther if he wants to, which I think he probably will eventually, but the upkeep of reinforcing these squads is probably going to be denying that second Panther.
Yeah, sure, I agree with you completely. I was just going to mention the Tiger Ace taking its toll on his manpower means that every single squad lost, for example, that machine gun on the right flank from the AEC, is going to be really hard to replace, and... Casper might find it really hard to take these victory points as time goes on. I mean, he's down to, what, two squads of Grenadiers, some Panzer Grenz, Stormtroopers, and two Pioneer squads at the moment. I mean, the Mortar squad can cap, but it's probably not going to be used for that. But anytime he loses one of those, he's probably not going to be able to replace it.
To counter the Tiger Ace, you don't necessarily have to kill it. You just have to, you know, not let it kill everything, and then you're kind of indirectly countering it. So we have the second Comet...
in one place at a time.
Yeah, the second Comet coming up now. Great, Phosphorus round. Has more range than the regular gun, so you can kind of snipe things with that one pretty effectively. And also, like, the P-Grens and the Stormtroopers have pretty expensive manpower reinforcement costs compared to Grens, so hard to do that one. AEC going in pretty deep here. Hopefully the engineers won't get wiped by the Tiger Ace. Faust actually comes through onto the AEC. One shot misses, so the AEC once again escapes death.
There's a second Comet coming onto the field. It could come on in time to join this fight, actually.
Yeah, the Six Pounders here is getting a little bit of veterancy as well. The Panther's going to have, I'm pretty sure, more armor than the Tiger Ace because it's Vet 2.
Yeah, that's probably right.
So Tiger doesn't get extra armor at Vet 2. It gets extra range and I think it's rate of fire. Greater accuracy and range. Accuracy. Oh, yeah, whatever. Yeah, so having, like... The Tiger at Vet 2 is much better at wiping squads, but then the Panther's better in tank engagements because you won't penetrate as reliably. Two Comets are here. They can certainly deal with these Grenadier squads. And is he actually charging into the Six Pounder and the Comet and the AEC? This could go horribly for Casper, depending on the penetration here. This Vet 2 Comet's getting very low. He will back away now, but now the Tiger Ace is being fired at. Actually does get the Comet in the end. Pops the smoke to disengage the Panzer Tactician, so a nice snipe there. Able to slowly... keep HQ at bay. Second VPs, two VPs have been captured by HQ Mole.
Yeah, another S minefield getting established on the left victory point. That one was seen whilst it was being built, I think, by the Vickers.
Man, that was tragic. That comment was a vet too. Like, the one good thing about versing the Tiger Ace is, like, you don't have to worry about it getting more veterancy. So, if your tank's fed up,
yeah,
it's kind of like, yeah, I'm catching up gradually. So,
yeah, it's true. Every time you get a level of veterancy, the Tiger Ace gets worse, effectively. And there's no way it can kind of, like, regain that gap.
Yeah. And currently, there's going to be a lot of downtime on these tanks for Casper. He has to repair these tanks. We will repair up his Tiger Ace now, but the Panther's still pretty low. Still has the man advantage, though. He has two vetted Grens, he has a P-Gren squad, Stormtroopers, so... the unit preservation is very important. The VPs have been neutralized. Two are captured by HQ Maul. And...
oh man, this AEC going in so deep again. I love how he's just flaunting this Panther in the double threat 3-star vet Panther.
Oh, actually, this Panther, are you sure about that, my friend? You're driving into this AT gun. Pops the smoke. AT gun doesn't actually fire through the smoke. He can attack ground through it to try and get the last shot. That church is very low and will get destroyed very quickly, so I don't think HQ Maul should try and capture that one. Vickers in that garrison will prevent the Stormtroopers from actually capping that one. So... oh, this is getting close.
This is certainly getting very close.
The problem...
I mean, it's pretty much a stalemate, right? So well, how do you break this for either player?
Ooh, okay, so the thing is with HQ, right, is he can't go double AT gun. Because if he does go a double AT gun, then Casper can just go Panzerwerfer and just completely wipe them. So I think it's smart that he hasn't gone double AT gun, despite it, you know, being what we would think pretty good against Panthers and Tiger Ace. If this game drags out long enough, if HQ can just hold on to his tanks, he'll eventually overtake Casper, because Casper is lacking in the fuel, because he doesn't have that fuel income. So,
okay.
I think
that there's enough time left in this game for another Firefly to come out and make a difference. I mean, he's at 127-ish fuel now.
Yeah. So HQ Mill, he has enough munitions. I would love to see a Firefly. Having the Firefly with the tulips would be fantastic with the Comet and the AT gun. As long as he holds onto his tank, this is the main thing. HQ Mill, he can't lose a Comet. He's lost, I think it's two of them now he's actually lost. At the same time, you know, Casper has lost two Panthers as well. And holding on to these engineers are pretty important for those repairs.
So, I don't know. Do you think HQ Mill is going to build for a Firefly or a Comet? I'm trying to think because we're kind of in the stalemate right now.
Yeah.
Where the player's really winning, but HQ Mill's kind of got the upper hand. Like, he's closing the gap in terms of score.
So I'm
trying to think, like, what's the line here? You know.
I would say Firefly because he has the munitions. I think previously when he went second Comet, he actually have enough munitions for tulips. Could be wrong though.
Sure.
I mean, Firefly's obviously going to be better against tanks, especially with the support of the Comet and the AEC. I mean, either's going to be good, but obviously the Firefly's cheaper. But in the Comet,
sure,
it's infantry. I think either is both viable. Like, I think either are both a good choice. I don't think it really matters which one he does, which one he goes for. I gotta say, casting this game has, like, really sobered me up, because this is just a fantastic game. Like, holy shit. Alright, here we go. Tiger Ace and the Panther actually going into the AT gun. They're popping the Blitzkrieg as well. Where is the AEC? A little bit too far off. 6 pounders on its own. May get wiped here by the Tiger Ace. It's pretty damn effective against the infantry and the AT guns. It's vet too, but he will lose it. Oh, nice timing there, because he was just in time to prevent HQ Mule getting a second vehicle. The church! No! Don't go into the church, my friend. Oh, no. Come on, HQ, you saw how low that church was.
Yeah, but maybe a misclick there. Maybe he just meant to move his squad, like, over to the left or something and accidentally clicked on the building, but that's going to cost him a squad, and he can ill afford to lose that. The thing is, even if he has the manpower to replace these squads, which he does, there's just not that much time left in the game, and losing vetted up units at this point, that's pretty severe.
It is.
So, I mean, looking at the balance of the forces here, the top left of the screen, the top right, looking at the supply, 98 for the Axis player, or just 54 for the Allied player. I think Casper might have just broken Mull, and he may be able to just sit on these victory points and ride through to a win now. We'll see if he's able to do so. I mean, the British player's making a move out here on the left flank, and he does command the right-hand victory point.
Oh, a
so
pack gun's being built.
It's not going to be a pushover.
I didn't actually see that
one. Oh, yeah, pack gun getting some good work done there.
That's smart.
Plucky AEC. 3-star at 20 kills after 45
minutes. All right, here we go. Panther and the Tiger Ace once again going in for it. There's no AT gun here, however, there's AEC, pops the smoke, but we may actually see it get taken out. But just kidding, because this is one slippery AEC, but he gets it! Just in the end there, nice work from the Panther.
I feel that's a little unfortunate for Mull. I thought that AC was just going to make it out there, and who wasn't rooting for the AEC there, you know?
Oh man. Alright, well...
So pulled for the underdog.
So, a second comment's coming out, but I think this pack's going to be a bit of a game changer against those two comments in the Panther and the Tiger Ace. That being said, though, it's a bit hard to use the pack because of the white phosphorus, able to just force away the pack. It has more range in the pack, so you can just kind of use that ability quite safely. Still, only one VP is captured, so HQ Mill has a bit of time. His points are cut off, though, so he's not really getting any income of fuel.
Yeah, I don't think he's really going to be able to make up enough resources for another armored unit this game, so it's down to manpower choices. He'll probably have enough time to get out one of those and make a difference. I don't know though. I mean, he's down to just two Vickers, two engineer squads, and he's going to need something to take these points. So
yeah, he just.
I was going to say you go for a super pounder, but I don't know.
He just lost his infantry section.
Might just have to go for engineers.
And that's a huge blow because he can't really afford to rebuild that because he also needs to rebuild an AT gun. That was just, you know, not paying attention. He actually walked it into the mortar and just got destroyed by the Tiger Ace. So, building an engineer squad, he needs an AT gun, but he also needs more capping squads. Yeah, it's looking grim.
Yeah. It's been a pretty long game, and Mull's been fighting tooth and nail, but he may just be feeling a little bit flustered, maybe even exhausted, because a couple of mistakes just creeping into his play here, and he's just lost, he nearly lost a Vickers. He's just lost some more engineers in mid. I don't know. I think if HQ is going to win this one, it's going to be an absolute miracle. But I don't want to take away from his game. This has been incredibly well played, and he's fought against pretty much like one of the most harsh Vermac tactics that you could go for. Just double fuel cache into greedy Panthers with a Tiger Ace for the late game. That's the stuff of nightmares for any allied player. And seeing the British forces do this well again really makes me want to get back out on the ladder with them, to be honest.
Yeah, but it was very smart from Castle because he knew how far ahead he was. HQ Mule, he's playing well, but he really did mess up his early game. You know, he did allow Casper to... Oh, what? Was that a mine that he hit? Heavy damage engine.
I think so.
Heavy damage engine on this comet.
Same time a comet ran. Was that his own mines that the comet
I think it may have been. Yeah, he may have detonated a telemine, and the Tiger Ace now is limping back, but the pack is moving up.
Here comes the pack gun. If we can see a phosphorus round on this pack gun, then the stricken Tiger will be exposed.
There already is.
That's the line right now for HQ. If there's a comeback possible, that has to be it.
Oh my god.
The phosphorus comes down and the pack gun's forced to fall back. It doesn't die though.
He needs to go in now.
With a Faust in the way.
He needs to go in because this Panther's getting repaired. Here we go.
He needs to spit his comets.
There's only one of them, however. He does have the emergency warspeed. I think he maybe just wants to repair his first.
He's gonna get Fausted.
But will he get the damage engine though? Will it actually... He got cancelled. Okay, he's going for it now.
He's
he may even
gone,
wipe it.
Sure.
No, he didn't have enough.
Bring engine.
Yeah, you need to get less than 75%. So he's trying to repair this Tiger Ace. The AT gun's backed away. The Panther's in his base. This is the moment to go in. HQ, he wants to repair his comets first, but he's wasting his time. Okay, here we go.
So I can appreciate why he wants to repair them.
Yeah, he needs to try and flank it. Now Tiger Ace doing great damage at long range. He needs to go in. He's apprehensive, but the Tiger Ace is getting so low. Comets go in. The Panther has reinforced. There is a Shrek in that house. However, HQ Mule, I believe, son. But oh, look at the VPs anyway. Three VPs
right.
Left. Trying to neutralize it in the middle.
Right.
Gets the stormtroopers.
He's decapping mid. Oh, he's not. He's not going to get mid. And
he won't get it.
If he's not going to get mid, then that will be game. But
man,
damn,
he should have. He should have at least tried to go in. Oh wow! What? Wow.
Yeah. What a game.
Holy shit! That game.
See, this is the joy of the live games lobby. Like, you get to see stuff as it's happening. It's super exciting. You don't know if it's going to be a good game or not. And, like, I don't know. I really enjoyed that one. That was really cool.
Yeah. He should have just gone for that Tiger Ace, like, once it was destroyed. Because the turret rotation isn't that fast. If you're able to flank it, especially because, like, I think it counts as a road in the middle. So he definitely could have flanked that one and maybe could have held that middle VP. So, Oh man, that game.
There was an opportunity there where he could have split the comets. If he would have sent like one like up to the left, like basically going directly north from where it was being repaired, whilst the other one went forward to where they are now, then he could have like gotten the Tiger Ace in a nice little crossfire there, and that would have made like the decision making with the Panther harder as well for the Axis player. I reckon he might have been able to chalk off the Tiger that way. I mean, it's like it's a long shot, and it's like that's with my caster's omnipotent like ha ha ha. This is what he should have done. But that's yeah. that's the line I would have suggested.
Well,
know?
I mean, for me, it was like he had 10 VPs left. He should have at least tried. You know, and, like, and even if you kill the Tiger Ace, you go out, like, with swag points, so it's what you always want to do.
That's right, yeah, I mean, like, the Tiger Ace is basically the big bully, like, the big bad guy of the game, and I think probably most of the people watching would have liked to have seen Mull make a bit of a comeback there. I don't know, that's how I feel anyway. But yeah, it's not going to happen, and, you know, credit where credit's due. Like, Kasparitas played a pretty damn slick, smooth game there with Vermax. He played it to its strengths, and you know, the plan came together pretty nicely, and in the end he's going to win, and by a reasonable margin, 132. I mean, it did look close there, but it's fair to say Casper was ahead for most of that.
Yeah, he played fantastically.
I'm gonna have to say goodbye. That is my doorbell. Thank you very much to everybody out there for watching. I'm gonna leave you to wrap this up. I have to go.
Cool,
bye.
Yeah, when we started this game, he was like, oh, I'm expecting a delivery, so I may have to get that during the cast. Fortunately, it came out now. So yeah, that was an awesome game. Thanks to Magpie for joining me. He's pretty new to the casting scene, but he's hilarious and very, very British. So do subscribe to his channel. I will leave his channel in the description and an annotation if I remember to put that up. Other than that though, thank you for watching, and I will see you next video.
Please subscribe to The General's Gentleman. If you enjoy our content, you can support us at patreon.com/generalsgentlemen.